evening, morning, and or afternoon Blood Bowl, I have somehow ruined everything. There we go. And everything has been restored once again. I have been joined here today with some full metal.
All of the metal. Every inch of the metal. Not just a little bit, but the full of the metal.
The full of the metal. And we got some G-Man Division 2 action. We got Merica FM, which is not how it's said, but it's how it's said now forever.
America!
That's what I wanted.
hang on. They're hanging Glassdoor? Really? This is definitely an English coach.
Yeah. It is. I think
it
is.
Because you know Glastonbury, right?
Huh?
Because you know Glastonbury, right?
No.
Glastonbury, the festival? That's where his...
That's stadium? Yeah, none of that makes any sense to me.
No, okay. Well, anyway. Versus Gerber.
Versus Gerber, and maybe Orks will work.
Dude, move your cursor. Your cursor's right across those poor rocks.
I'm not going to. It's too late now. Because I'm behind. I'm in the future.
You're in the future?
I live in the future.
Hello, future Gamba Man.
Future Gamba Man. Looks like Mr. Coach Johnny's got a wizard and a bribe and an Apo. Mr. Gerber's got some rerolls and an Apo.
He bought an Apo.
Yeah?
I can't. Especially with Brett's, I don't think necessarily the Apo's worth it.
Oh, okay, that's a good thing to point out, because,
I mean, if you sling over his inducements for me a second again, yeah? Yeah, I would have took a second bribe.
Yeah, yeah, bribes are always good, especially with the peasants. Looks like Gerber has been kind of struggling a little bit because he's got some regular linemen filling in some holes.
Yeah, there's not as many.
I know he had a death recently and lost one of his black orcs, and that was a pretty big blow.
Yeah, that always hurts an old team with, because black orcs are expensive as well.
Yeah, they're not cheap.
But talking of inducements for a second, I genuinely prefer two babes over an apple.
And a bribe.
If you're gonna take an apple, take two babes instead. Every time. Perfect defense, well that's upsetting. Well, because, you know, we've just seen Johnny here put valuable pieces on the line, and suddenly perfect defenses come around, and it's like, yep.
And they're going to get punched in the face.
I think I would have liked to have seen Gerber really high strength this up and throw all man's line, knowing where Johnny set up, he could have really outstrength that front line and stopped a lot of blocks coming before they even start.
That's a really good point. Yeah, he could have thrown all the Black Orcs and Blitzers on the line and made it really difficult. Especially since Johnny's got some peasants.
He's put a Black Orc on the line that he didn't have on the line previously, but frankly, he was still a two dice block, so it's not really a problem. You know, it hasn't actually caused Johnny any concerns whatsoever.
Yeah, yeah. Looks like we might be getting an early foul.
You're ahead of me, it's definite. Because watching the early blocks.
Oh.
I just watched the linemen go down to the both down. But yeah, now it looks like we're seeing an early foul. I'd have brought maybe more pieces of this.
Well, let me tell you from the future, I'm not sure if he's going to continue with that idea.
Yeah, I just watched the... Oh no, you got the ball. Nice. I wouldn't have rerolled that, to be honest.
Because it's so far away that it's kind of out of danger.
Yeah, that's a burnt reroll. You didn't. I'd have left the ball until I'd have finished my move and my pieces. Maybe lined up for a kick in the nudges, and I would have gone. I mean, with a bribe, I'd have gone for a kick in the nudges. Because if you just check the sidelines for me, Orcs will work. Do not have a single reserve. What's Johnny's reserve look like?
Should be seeing it now. It's a nil.
He's got a peasant with guard. That's pretty useful.
That is pretty.
That's also work. Have nothing with Johnny. Also, see that's, I suppose it's because we're quite a new team. He needs to build up some peasants.
Yep. Peasants are good. Peasants are great for fouling. Because they're cheap.
Yeah, it's. I mean, bribes on Bretonian teams. Just hire more peasants. And then you don't need the bribe.
Yeah, you can pay. You can play them very ratmen, where you can just have like a 12 deep bench.
I like a 13 bench on a Bright.
Shoot, yeah, why not? Peasants are cheap, 40,000. I mean, yeah, when I play ogres, I take...
Taking an extra peasant, you're not even giving a bib away.
Yeah, like I was going to say, playing ogres, I take a full bench, because snotlings cost nothing, and your team value barely goes up from them.
I have to say, though, Merica FM are... Oh, that was a nice kill, but they're throwing rerolls away here.
Yeah.
Just, again, because of a bad choice of order and blocking, I wouldn't have blocked with the peasants until I've blocked with my wrestling and block pieces. That was quite ballsy to dodge out of that tackle zone, too.
Especially after using a...
A reroll. That's insanely ballsy. I mean, he has got dodge.
He does have dodge.
But, no, I'd have rolled the other dice first, and then rolled the peasant blocks afterwards, because peasants have no real useful skills, so...
Yeah,
and I see why he's not benching the lineman peasants.
Yeah, he's lost a couple of players in his last couple of matches as well. So both these teams have actually come out of the meat house, you know what I mean? They've already been slaughter for the lambs. This is one of the teams that I thought about rolling as again, too, because peasants are fun for fouling.
Yeah, peasants are hilarious. I'm actually playing a Bretonian team in Lupak's Cripple Cup this week, tomorrow.
I'll be there with you. I'll make sure I join you. I'm going to try to get a good night's sleep.
The one-minute turns make it interesting, but it's good fun. And just being able to foul the peasants in a format where you know the opponents is having a pop three is hilarious.
Oh, yeah. That's, as they would say, amazing. Amazing! So,
I like what Gerber's trying to do here, where he's trying to focus on the, you know, blitzing down the knights.
Yeah,
that's very big for Brett. I mean, the knights are the backbone of a Bretonian team, and really you need to try and take down. If you can take down those knights, I mean, the peasants are never going to handle the ball, dude. Unfortunately, the knights are actually quite tough, especially now they all have bludge on singles.
Mm-hmm.
They're actually quite difficult to bring down.
I was gonna say. We're gonna see another. That's it, and all the rerolls are gone. See, unfortunately, with those early use rerolls, it kind of leaves him in a vulnerable spot now because he's got a lot of turns left until the drive's over. But I was gonna say,
why did he go for it though?
I don't know.
What is he hoping to accomplish with this maneuver?
So, yeah, because
he can't get far enough away that he's gonna be outside of orc range anyway. Even if he passes it, he's gonna be within orc range.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah.
And that's another thing I come back to with Blood Bowl, is you always need to know what you're aiming to do. You know, you don't do something just because you can. You do it because you've got a reason for doing it. And that guy going for it once there, he hasn't even passed the ball to him, so...
Yeah. Yeah, you're 100% right. That's just another burnt reroll that could have been used for something else.
I'd say not one reroll that Johnny's used this game needed to be used.
Well, I would say the block one was, but that also could have been avoided. You know what I mean?
If a peasant goes down for a block, it's not the end of the world, dude.
It really isn't, but since it was before he got to block with his blitzers and his yeomen, it kind of did
Ooh.
Disrupt the order.
Ooh, that was good for the orcs.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
He just ran in, knocked him out, and then got the ball. That's really good for him.
That was a really good roll. Sorry, guys, that we're a little different. Mr. Metal is trying to get Windows 10 up and running, and it's not quite working well with what we normally stream together with, so there is a little bit of a delay.
I mean, it's okay. I mean, ultimately, you know, a lot of what we're able to do, all we've been asked to do with this video, is to provide feedback on what the coaches could have done better.
Yeah, this is actually, honestly, I think all the new coaches have come and watched this since we're giving pretty crucial feedback to... what a lot of new players do, which can hurt them in the long run.
Yeah, I've just watched this and I can instantly tell Johnny is a new player. And I don't mean to bash on him for that. And I'm not bashing on him for that. In the slightest. Because everyone was new once, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Everyone had to learn how to play.
Yeah. I learned Tuesday. That's when I learned how to play Blood Bowl. Last Tuesday. I remember it well. Yeah. It was terrible.
And see, that could have been... There could have been so many more things you could have done here to get this ball back. Like, moving that guy up. You know, it's... I don't know.
It ended up working for him, though. You know what I mean?
It did, but...
Now he's kind of in it.
Who he burnt a reroll on?
Yeah.
To go for it. Ended up running back down the field.
Yep. Yeah.
Which made the go for it and therefore the reroll entirely useless. He's getting quite brave with these two dices. These one dices, sorry.
Yeah. Well, he had wrestle on one of them, so I mean, kind of safe.
Oh, he's certainly not in as bad a spot as he was at the end of his last turn. But still, I mean, he's got a very vulnerable ball at the moment.
Yes, that is very true.
Especially with this RG4 Mighty Blow Blitzer. He's quite scary.
Oh, yeah, he is.
He's actually the dream for an alt push, to be honest.
He is, and in the last game, I thought he was going to carry the team a lot more than he did. He didn't need to lean on him as much on his last match with him. He was there, and he was a threat, and you were always like, oh man, when's he going to do some crazy elf bullshit? Oh. And there we go, turnover. Peasant getting to give someone the good old punch in the face.
Yep, that's fine.
Yeah.
Not a big deal. I don't know if I'd have rolled that. I genuinely think you're better off
not rolling it.
Peasant stood up and you stood up.
Yeah.
And just negating tackle, well, assists everywhere than you were taking that block. It was again, not worth it. Oh, that's really bad for him. That's the Agi Monster down.
Yeah.
So that's great for the Plutonium Coach right now.
Yeah, and that's also the next block you're about to see is also another good one. I mean, it's just a lineman, but removing pieces off the pitch is always a good thing.
Well, Orks thrive on being, you know, the stronger coach.
Yeah, having the numbers game. And
not even necessarily the numbers, just as much as the strength. That was a nice Dauntless as well. Obviously, focusing on the Black Orks, trying to get them off the damn ball carrier is very good for the break. Oh, is he blitzing with the ball carrier, though? That's
dangerous.
That could have went badly.
Yeah, that's always really, really dangerous. He had dodge. It didn't. I would have much rather have gone for the dodge. It went well.
Oh, every time.
even with my dwarfs, I tend to dodge a little more than you should, but it's just a safer roll.
And again, I'm confused with something else and stuff. He's got a bribe, yeah?
Yeah.
He needs his foul things. If you've got a bribe, just foul. It doesn't even really matter. If you've got peasants, foul, man. Watch Gengar play a little bit. Realize that fouling is A-okay in 90% of turns.
Yeah, especially when you have cheaper players that you can afford to get rid of. Definitely stock up on the peasants and get a deeper bench.
But yeah, especially, say, even having said that, you know, he's had turns where there's been people down where he could have stamped the granny out of people, and he hasn't stamped the granny out of people, and it confuses me. But again, that could be down to being a new coach, and a lot of new coaches kind of are very anti-foul.
Yeah. And I can see that. They think it wrong because it's called a foul. And in most cases, in most games, it'd be considered unsportsmanlike, but...
Put in Blood Bowl. It's part of the course, dude.
Yeah,
now,
yeah.
He's going to run this directly in, isn't he?
No, he's stalling it out.
That's a good choice.
Now, that's exactly... I'd be going for the foul right there instead of the block. You got a good blitzer on the ground, ready to get the boot put in him.
It even looks like he's moving up too.
Yeah, he looks like he is. He made a couple risky dodges, but let's see if the foul turns out. Oh, shit!
Well, spoiler alert, we know something's gonna work here.
Oh, shit! Yeah, watch that. And,
Oh, that's the RG4 guy with dodge. He had two RG4 guys?
Yes.
Is dead?
Dead into dead.
Ooh, that's gonna hurt Gerber.
Oh, man. That is a...
Did he just 2 dice uphill a Black Hawk afterwards for... Just to kind of prove a point. And then, eventually, you know.
You're beating a dead horse.
Again, why did you block the Black Hawk? Why did you block the lineman?
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes it's okay. Sometimes you want to take the one dice, but you only want to take the one dice when you have block. If you're going after the ball carrier.
Sometimes you want to just take the one dice if there's zero risk to your team.
Or yeah.
Maybe a peasant going down. But there's a lot of risk to these linemen being free because they can then hit, move up and support attacks on more valuable players.
Mm-hmm.
And also, that's your guard piece. Never one dice with your guard piece.
Yeah, you want him standing up at all times. His job is to stand up and be like, everybody, I got this.
Nobody move. I got this.
Nobody move. I have guard. It's going to be A-okay.
I like this defensive setup here. Definitely can. I think I'm expecting to see Johnny stall out the 8th turn here. This would be just fine for him.
Yeah, that's a perfect dwarf stall out.
A dwarf stall out?
Yeah, if you get to the 8th turn, it's a perfect stall for a dwarf.
That's true. But this, again, talking about pieces, I didn't need to move to pieces. This, I feel like this guy with the yeoman, maybe not necessarily the best position for him, but, yeah, whatever.
He's starting to get more aggressive with the fouls, which is good.
It's that moment that he realized he still has fucking, a bribe.
Gerber playing it smart. He's got a lineman in position if he actually can get the turnover.
But he'd have to have the turn from just heaven at this point.
Oh, yeah, it'd have to be a,
And that's super important, nonetheless, to have a lineman in scoring position.
Always. You? Always have someone who can be in scoring position. You never know. If you can get the one dice and then the handoff to a throw, and you just turned a really bad drive for you into an amazing drive for you.
See, what I'd like to see happen here, because, as I said, we just had great play into what I think is terrible play. Does he have three agi? Four pieces? Oh, no, it was... Anyway, what I'd love to see here is them to not have done this, to be honest. No, they could have done something much more fun with that lineman. I'd have loved to have seen the peasant block the lineman in front of the ball carrier and then have the ball carrier just surf him. Obviously, it's risky because his rerolls necessarily, but surfing is huge.
It's always an armor break. Every time you surf, guaranteed armor break. So,
with Mighty Blow, no less.
Yes, with Mighty Blow. No, I thought Mighty Blow was for the beer stand.
Oh, yeah, sorry, yeah.
You're thinking of Gengar Stadium.
They all came up. That was a really good knockout set of rolls for the Orks.
Yeah, he's still down two, so our Brett's are still up one.
The knockouts comeback is huge for him.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
If the knockouts hadn't come back, he'd have basically... We could have had like a 3-0 or a 4-0 easily.
I was going to say, yeah, if the knockouts didn't come back, that's GG. GG.
Because then you just leverage the strength you've got on the pitch to just absolutely beat the shenanigans out of the rest of his players.
Now, here's one thing I want to ask you. In this instance, right, it's turn 8, and you got to put people on the line to get sacrificed. Peasants or blockers?
Peasants.
Really?
Peasants are sacrificial every day of the week. Yeah, peasants exist to die, dude.
That's true. Blockers can wrestle, but then they can get fouled afterwards.
Yeah, you don't... In this situation, there is... The only beneficial scenario that could happen here would be a riot. In which case... He's already done the right thing by stacking his higher movement pieces, the knights, on the outside.
Yeah.
But the likelihood of a riot is very, very small. So frankly, they both got a reroll. That's very useful for nobody.
Yeah.
Because I'm not, the Orks haven't set up to look for a one turn here. Not that Orks are particularly great at one turns. They can do it, but it's scary.
Yeah, I was going to say they'd be a little more inclined to do it if they had a Gabo and a Troll.
Yeah, they don't tend to do running one-turners very well.
No, just like Dwarfs. It's possible, but do you really want to try it is the question.
Oh god, I would literally buy someone a Steam game if they can get a Dwarf.
Oh, I know. I'd like to see it too, at least have a little video clip of it. Here comes that Vanity Pass. And it's good.
Did we get a vanny pass before a foul?
No foul.
We need to see a foul here, dude.
I think Gerber's
he's
a little...
He's worried about getting sent off.
Yeah, he's kind of low on the bodies, and he's kind of like, listen, the risk of... The reward of getting rid of a peasant isn't that high.
We're the Bretonian team with no bench. He really needs the numbers, though, dude.
I know.
I'd have taken the foul, to be honest, with one of your linemen. Just to try and clear out another peasant.
Does he have... He doesn't
he's
have
now
a,
equal. He's now equal on numbers because the KO didn't come back.
Yeah.
But if he'd have got a foul and done another injury, even if he'd have got sent off after, on top of that injury, he'd have brought the numbers down even further. And when the numbers start dwindling, he's still got three Black Orks.
Yeah,
which
and
are much stronger
much
than
stronger.
The
Blitzers do have the Dauntless, though.
That's true, but at the same time, you know, you're still relying on an extra dice roll.
Yeah, it's not consistent strength.
And also, Dauntless doesn't work defensively.
No, it does not. Be cool if it did, though. Totally would break the game. It would break the game.
They would be incredibly difficult to block down.
There'd be riots. There'd be riots in the streets. People would be going crazy.
Better riots on the streets than on our fields, right?
I don't know. Sometimes I always hope for them on the fields. Sometimes I'm like, please have a riot. Quick snap on top of his kickoff return.
Would you say you predict a riot?
No, I said I prefer a riot.
No, I was gonna say no, but would you predict a riot?
But if they made Dauntless work both ways, it'd be the smallest riot ever, and it'd be concealed to just Reddit.
Well, Reddit's a big place, dude.
It is. It's very small in the Blood Bowl world, though.
That's true.
Compared to all the other giant subreddits out there.
Oh, that's a nice touchback. In actual fact, the fact that it touched back was made the quick snap and the...
Everything
and
pointless.
The kickoff return actually work against him.
Yeah.
Because now the guy's just in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah,
I have to be a little bit upset by the fact that it touched back there. I'd be like, no, I'm actually offended by this.
I would have to say the one thing he's doing right now is blocking the line down before getting his ball carrier safe is something that I wouldn't personally want to do.
No, not when you put the ball carrier in the front line, especially because did he one dice some of those?
No.
Yeah, because there's a guard piece. He one dice them.
No, he's strength 4.
Yeah, strength 4 against a 3 plus a guard.
It's a one dice.
But what? Why?
It's all learning.
And also one dice for the blitzer as well, dude.
It's all
on the guard piece.
All learning experiences.
See, now this, for me, right here, is a perfect opportunity to foul the granny out of a guard piece.
Yeah. I 100%
agree. Well, he's moved all his pieces down, so he can't. That guard piece, I would have... Oh, my word. Fire from the sky.
Yep.
No real damage, but...
Yep.
At the same time, exposed the ball carrier.
It was a smart... That was actually, I would say, a good fireball. That was a good use of fireball. If it pays off, who knows?
I don't see a way it's actually going to pay off, though, is the problem. Because he's one dice.
Yeah.
I feel like it would have been much more valuable to him to have one dice with the Yeoman.
Because he's got Wrestle.
Because he's got Wrestle, which is so much better than blocking a blocker when you need to take the ball off him.
Yeah, that's one of the nice things about the Yeoman is that they have Wrestle, which is such an underestimated skill, you know?
I really hate, though, that they renamed them Blitzers for Blood Bowl, because they were Yeoman originally in the original team, and then they renamed them Blitzers to Blockers, sorry. And it's like, but they don't have blocks, so why call them blockers when they're giving them Wrestle?
That's why I call them knights and yeomen and peasants. That's their real names.
Yeah. Absolutely, dude. I was just making sure that anyone who wasn't aware of that situation with the
That's smart. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Because they'll be sat there going, why can't I buy any yeomen for my Brett team?
Yeah, they're just blockers. We're just going by their original names.
That was a good block. Pushing the ball free in a chain push.
Yeah.
It's really nice, though.
Oh, and it put him in a good, a dangerous spot. He's potatoing, which is kind of scary.
Dude, you don't hate potatoing.
I do it all the time. It's just scary. That's all I'm saying. His little green potato. At least he's got Blodge, so, I mean, that helps a little bit.
at least he also didn't decided really. What, he's got a blocker with dodge. That's really nice for him. He's got a Yawning with dodge. That's
really good. Nice.
Dodge and wrestle. That's gonna make him hard to take down. That's and then good. He instantly wrestles the guy to the ground.
You gotta wrestle, man. It's all about that wrestling.
Rootin', tootin', wrestling, cowboys.
Oh, forgot about the tackle.
Oh my god, he just got some power.
Yeah. You're gonna see something you forgot about tackle. Being aware of your player's skills really makes a big difference too.
Yeah, that was bad for him. That was very bad for him.
Yep.
Especially when he, you know, that was. To be fair, the Orks aren't in a great position anyway, though. So.
Yeah, he's in a really good position because it's either gonna go. The Orks are now gonna have to score really quickly, and then he gets kicked back to, or he's gonna be able to clear it.
Tackle in return. The tackle piece didn't work here. Doesn't actually cause any injuries, but certainly brings down the yeoman there, who was thought he had like the fancy footwork needed to survive.
Oh shoot! A black orc getting some much wanted revenge. Wait for it. Because he's under delay. He's...
Ooh!
Yeah! And that was a dead to a dead.
Good night. Was that knight particularly skilled?
Blodge.
Well...
Oh, no, he wasn't. Level 1.
Even with a level 1 knight, I mean... Like I said at the beginning, at the top of the match, killing off or, you know, putting the knights off the field... really cripples Antonian's response.
Tackle doing a thing. Man. That's nice and bloody.
And that was how the West was won, dude.
Yeah. I really like the Black Orcs animations when they're punching. The uppercuts.
Yeah, you really feel them put the work. I mean, to be fair, I think Cyanide did, as much as everyone likes to hate Cyanide, they did a great job on a lot of the design work on these teams. And they put in a lot of things that you don't necessarily expect to see. Like, for example, did you know that because Fend is a thing, pieces with, say, Frenzy have a different block animation when they're hitting someone they can't follow up on?
I did not. I will have to look at that a little more closely.
Playing rats, it turned up because my rat ogre has beaten up peasants in the past.
Yeah.
And it turns into this like double-handed uppercut claw sweep that just sends them flying for days.
Huh.
And it's actually really good.
Huh. It's the little things, you know. Now,
yeah, the fact that they thought they had to do that. Now, that was a good touchdown, and the reason for that is he has to score again.
That's what I was gonna say. That's what I wanted to say. I was gonna be like that. I wanted to make sure you agreed that it was a good touchdown. Stalling out there, playing for the draw would not have been the best choice.
Unfortunately, well, I don't know. Playing for the draw may have been a choice because these, you know, neither of these coaches are in a position where they desperately need the wins. They're already in Division 2, so they can't fall further.
Well, I mean, trying to stall out and playing for the draw that way would have been dangerous.
Oh, yeah, very much so. I mean, yeah. his pieces were very bad.
Playing for the draw now, trying to just hold them out and not playing super aggressive, I think is a smart play.
Yeah, that's definitely where I was going with that.
Yeah. Yeah, I 100% agree. Screening, slowing them down, getting the blocks where you can get them.
Especially now he's got the numbers advantage, he really needs to start working the body of the Bretonians.
What are you, some sort of boxer now? He's got to work the body. Work the body. Rocky, come on. Get out of here.
I don't think that's an unfair commentary, dude. He's got to work the body a little bit now. This is, you know, ultimately attrition on the team is the equivalent of working the body in boxing.
Yeah, oh, I don't disagree. He's got to, especially since they're probably going to be playing each other a lot next season, or at least once. So there's going to be a grudge match.
A lot like that one time.
A lot like that one time that they'd be playing each other. They're both going to remember the fact that they've lost some players, and they're both going to be a little bitter.
What are they doing as coaches? They need to remember the fact that they've... I need to see more fouls, because I think I've seen Johnny foul twice, and he bought a bribe.
He used the bribe. It's gone. And he got ejected.
I don't care. I still need to see more fouls.
I don't know. He's kind of... Isn't he players down? 1, 2, 3... 8,
yeah,
9...
At this point, he needs to bring... He needs to actually do some damage. Because he's just going to get out strength.
That's true, but he still has some knights, so he can try to out agile.
Nah, I know. My point, I think, being is... Uh-huh. His blood is withered.
Yep.
He's against a stronger team.
Yep.
He really, really needs to get some numbers going in his favor, because right now, there's every probability Gerber could take the ball off.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can definitely see that.
Nice power on the blodge piece. That's really good. That, he was a little bit exposed, I feel. I don't know why he was up on the line there. You know, Johnny's in a real dangerous position.
Oh, yeah. No, he's only got a little bit of coverage. He kind of fixes it in a couple seconds. But then he makes a block that was kind of risky.
I just think, especially, you know, we have a very generous, to my mind, you know, one of the things about our league is we have very generous turn timers.
Yes.
These turns are going over so fast.
Well, it's also a replay, so it takes out all the thinking.
No, I know, but at the same time, it feels like there's not as much thinking necessarily being done as could be done.
Okay, I can see
this
that.
This mighty blow isn't damaging these armor 7. I've got to feel bad for Gerber here, that this peasant armor's holding.
Yeah, I've been there. I understand. I understand the feeling.
I'm a Skaven coach. I feel bad when my armor works. I actually sit there and people are blocking my line rats down. I'm like, I feel really bad for you that you just blocked 4 line rats and did no damage.
You don't feel bad for them, don't lie.
No, I really do, because I know the pain of failed armor breaks.
Well, that's because you got a terrible blitzer.
This is true.
But, in all theory, he should be the best blitzer who ever lived. And,
well, he hasn't got piling on you, but, you know, soon.
Yeah. Soon.
I feel like if he gets piling on, there's no way he can't succeed.
Yeah, I would say. He scores a lot of stuns, so it's not like he's not getting the armor breaks. It just doesn't seem to stick.
But, this, again, your coverage is... I feel like this is dangerous.
Where I'm at, he's got an okay screen set up, but there's still, like, some easy dodge rolls that can be made and kind of screw him.
Well, I'm looking at it, I can't imagine a screen that would work here, because essentially he's just going to get blocked out by higher strength.
Mm-hmm.
He can clear, this could be cleared very easily by the Orc course. This is not an effective, oh god, he passed.
Yep.
Okay, that was better.
Yeah, he ends up in a better spot, but
the passing's a good spot, but at the same time, I like that he uses rerolls more frugally this turn, but I think that's because less dice fail.
Ooh.
Is that a one dice?
Yep.
That's incredibly brave.
Yep. To a dub skull. And he's managing to free him up, and if I were him, I'd just run it in, unless you need another turn to not do going for it.
No, I'd run it in at this point.
Yeah, you're right.
You gotta reroll.
Nope.
Actually, to be fair, you know what I'd actually do?
Huh.
Run it the fuck up the field, and then foul the shit out of the only guy that can reach him.
That's, yeah. Yeah, which is also happens to be a agility for blodge piece.
Because leaving him just on the ground to chill, nah, man.
That's dangerous, yeah.
Look at this, he can get a plus 2 here. No, where are you going, peasant? Foul him!
I don't think they can hear you. I don't think that's how it works.
Foul him! Kick him in the fucking dick!
I think you've been hanging out with Gengar too much.
No, man. There's a dick kicking for that orc in that orc's future. That needs to happen, and it didn't.
It's not going to now.
He's got two RG4 block. Has he got two? I'm pretty sure he's got two RG4.
Yeah, he might be punished for it. Nope. Rot row.
Yeah. My issue here is that 50-50. Ooh, that peasant didn't work.
Yeah.
That peasant pair eyes.
Yeah, that peasant
But here's the thing, if the right action had been taken, you know, our hearts didn't have to be in our mouths right now.
Yeah, yeah, no. The foul could have came, and the foul...
I love the Dark Souls-esque Praise the Sun.
Oh, dude, that's my favorite. That is...
I've got to believe it's there as a thing to Dark Souls. Oh, really do.
Yeah, it's an homage, for sure. So, there you have it. There was... I hope you guys got to take away some of, Gengar's sagely advice, and,
I'm not Gengar.
Now you are. Foul! Foul! Foul some more! Why aren't you fouling? Kick him in the nutters!
You're playing Bredonians, yeah? You have two things going for you. You have knights, who are just actual brilliant pieces, and you have fouling! If you don't foul, you're only using half your team!
I'm not disagreeing with you. I'm just saying... There were times when I forgot that you were Steve, and remember and thought you were Gengar. Just saying.
Okay, for me personally, although the Praetorian buff has been really nice with the, you know, giving them AG access, so you know, getting dodge on the knights and stuff. You still need to remember that they're Praetorians. They're not a tier one team. They're
no.
a tier 1.5 at best, even with the buff. And if you don't use them to their actual complete strengths, you're better off playing any other team in the game.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, I 100%. If you're going to play them more as an agi team, you're better off playing humans. Just vanilla humans. You're going to have a passer. You're going to have catchers. You know.
You're going to have, like, people with strength access.
Yeah, you're going to have an ogre, which is going to do a much better job.
I know Yeoman have strength access, but they also don't have block. They have wrestle.
They have wrestle, which
is far less useful.
It's...
You don't really want that much guard on them because they fall over a lot.
Because
they fall themselves over. But at the same time, you don't want to watch your guard piece go, I'm just going to have a quick lie down.
Yeah, yeah, I'm kind of torn on that. But, we will see you guys next time. I hope you guys enjoyed this and got some good info out of it. We'll try to do it again. We're a little more critical when people are playing. Hopefully we can get the Google up.
As well, do remember, I'm not being horrible. When I said you made mistakes, it wasn't like I wasn't trying to hurt your feelings, or I genuinely just think there were situations there that you could have done better. And if you want to be a better coach, sometimes you're going to have it told to you the hard way. Sometimes you're just going to get absolutely stomped across the field, and it's going to feel like being diced, and it isn't. It's just the fact that you're outplayed.
Yeah, yeah. That happens. I have to come to terms with that pretty much 24/7, because I'm terrible.
Terrible?
Terrible. Just terrible, PD.
Terrible!
Alright, well guys, it was fun, and we will see you on the flippity-flop.
Stay classy, folks.